Hello and welcome to the episode 80 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. The episode features the first evening engagement at the Cavern Club, some more work for the Help film, and a weird session in Abbey Road. On the 21st of March 1961, the Beatles with Pete Best on drums played their first nighttime concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool after 11 lunchtime engagements. As reported by BeatlesBible.com, here's what the then venue owner Ray McFaul recalled about that first evening show in the book The Cavern. Bob Wooler had told me about the Beatles, and I had become aware of the Beatles earlier when Pete Best's mother, Mo, phoned me to say, "My son is in a wonderful group, they do very well, so why don't you book them?" My response was, "I'll let you know." When it came to beat music, Bob was the expert, and I relied on him to select the groups. He told me that the Beatles had come from Hamburg, and he was at the Litterland Town Hall and saw their return, and he said, "You've got to have them." Brian Kelly, who ran Litterland Town Hall, booked them for all his shows, which were all on a Wednesday. "I couldn't have them on Wednesday, I wasn't open on Thursday or there would be modern jazz, and the weekend was traditional jazz, and so I decided to book them on a Tuesday." This was the Blue Jeans guest night, and they wanted good, well-organized, clean beat groups, ones that weren't too loud and wild, and they would suggest groups to me. Afterwards, three of the Blue Jeans tackled me in Matthew Street, and they were most upset. As far as they were concerned, the Beatles didn't have the musical talent, and they weren't clean, fresh, and well-organized. I said that if the place is full, there are a lot more people watching the Blue Jeans. In 1962, there was another engagement at the Cavern Club for the Beatles, still featuring Pete Best on drums. This time, it was a lunchtime gig between 12 noon and 2 p.m. Two engagements for the soon-to-be Fab Four on the 21st of March 1963. To begin with, after a 10 a.m. rehearsal in the Studio One of BBC Piccadilly Studios in London, the Beatles recorded three songs for the BBC radios on the scene between 1 and 2 p.m. Misery, Do You Want to Know a Secret, and Please Please Me. The program was aired on the 28th of March between 5 and 5:29 p.m. After the session, the trip to reach the venue of the Montez Row package tour stop of the night was relatively short this time. We're talking about the ABC Cinema in Croydon, a mere 10 miles or 16 kilometers from London. In 1965, while the rest of the crew and the Beatles' doubles were busy in Salzburg, Austria, shooting a scene at the Randstad station and in a nearby road tunnel, the Fabs had a day of rest in Obertauern. Time to remind you to be fab and visit www.simonmas.com/support if you want to find ways to support this series. No donation is too small, and you can always make sure that your friends come and listen if you are short on cash. Not quite the same, but still very much appreciated. Thank you for any help you feel like giving. 1967. It was a strange recording session tonight at Abbey Road. Between 7 p.m. and 2:45 a.m, the Beatles were meant to complete both Getting Better and Lovely Rita. Ringo Starr was not needed and did not attend the session, which saw a number of other guests. The Beatles' publisher Dick James, NEMS and later Apple's employee Peter Brown, Ivan Vaughan, who had introduced Paul McCartney to John Lennon in 1957, and writer Hunter Davis, who had been commissioned to write an authorized biography of the band, which was published in 1968 with the title The Beatles. Getting Better was the first song to be tackled, with a listening and two reduction mixes to make space for an overdub of the backing choirs of the piece, sung by Paul, John, and George. John was already feeling a bit strange, but when the time came to switch the attention on Lovely Rita, producer George Martin realized that he was feeling unwell and decided to bring John to the roof of the studio to take some fresh air. It was the only available option to do so while staying away from the fans that, as usual, were stashing out of the premises waiting for any sign of life from their idols. Then, Martin returned to the control room. When George Harrison and Paul McCartney were told where John was, they rushed to the roof themselves. They had realized what had happened. John used to bring with him a small silver Heart Nouveau pill box which contained stimulants and LSD pills which he experimented with during the day and the sessions. Evidently, he had taken the wrong pill and was starting to experience a bad LSD trip when he felt sick. The roof where Martin had innocently brought John was 30 feet high and had no railing, and so George and Paul were scared that John might fall or jump down in a drug-induced moment of confusion. They rushed John back into Studio 2, where they could look after him. Needless to say, the session came to a stop. When it became clear that John couldn't keep working, having taken too big a dose of LSD, Paul and assistant Moll Evans brought him to Paul's house in 7 Cavendish Avenue, where Paul decided to take LSD and share the trip with his mate. It was McCartney's second trip. In Paul's recollection of the event in Barry Miles' book Many Years From Now, they spent the night looking into each other's eyes, hallucinating. Back in Abbey Road, George Martin completed Lovely Rita with a piano solo overdubbed on the rhythm track. A lot of tape speed tricks were applied on the song. The rhythm track had been recorded in one key, at one tape speed. The tape was slowed down during the piano solo, and then a third speed was used to mix the song up in mono, with a final result sounding more or less in E flat major. These experiments with changing the speed of the tape, a technique called varispeed, made the mixing quite laborious. It took 15 attempts to produce 2 decent mono mixes, which were edited together before the session was wrapped up. And with this, we have reached the conclusion of another episode of What a Fab Day. Tomorrow, among other things, we'll talk about another Abbey Road session. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.